wake of the specialists, the road crew gets involved. Rudy, the guitar tech, invents the later. Kind of a fruity drink loaded with rum or vodka or something. We called it later because you'd be later for the dance than you ever thought you'd be. We would have these parties, especially if you're playing multiple nights in a city, 2-3 nights at the local arena. And after the first night, we'd have a big party. And then he invented super laters, because they'd make you later for the dance than even the laters would make you late-like. This gets complicated. We had to build him a special road case, like 6.5 feet tall. It opened up like a closet with three big sections containing three industrial strength blenders, circuit breakers, a car stereo, mixing gear, disco lights, and an ice bucket. It was called Raving Rude's Libation Station. The biggest road case anyone had ever seen. And we would set up a tent open air and have one rompin' stompin' barbecue. More about this later. Hey, everybody values their free time on their off time supremely because you work so hard when you're on the road. You develop what it takes that takes you away. Your passport, kinda. For me, I always took bicycles or cross-country skis. Golf is very, very popular on the road, though. It's a meditational kind of gig. You really drift away. You lose yourself into the art form. Not unusual to have six buses pull up in front of a hotel at 5:30 in the morning, pending a day off, and nine guys on the crew would get off with full-blast golf bags, two-tone golf shoes, a pair of shorts and jack boots, a headband, and $2,700 worth of cool golf clubs. You got to know all the cool golf courses all over the world. In Japan, the golf course outside of Osaka is super high-tech. You don't carry your golf clubs. Nobody does. There's a little track, like the railing at a dog track, and there are these little electric holding carts that are connected. You put the bag of golf clubs on the thing and it runs down the track to the next hole. And there are attendants at every hole wearing white little uniforms. Every hole has a drink stand and a food place. Or the course we played at near Louisville, Kentucky, where a farmer built himself a pitch and putt, three par out on the great rolling hills. There's a little shack with a coffee can. It's 50 cents to play the holes, another 50 if you rent one of the clubs, and there's a dozen clubs leaning against the wall. There's nobody there. He's out cutting hay rows. There's a little sign, handwritten. It says, "You're on the honor system." Roth Show.